Dank je, Chairperson. Chairperson, hierdie naweek vier ons Mensenregte Dag in Suid-Afrika. En hierdie debat gaan oor die bevordering van mensenregte in die era van COVID-19. Maar het ons as Suid-Afrikaners werkelijk iets om te vier? Ongelukkig is dit 'n feit wat sedert Maart 2020 bewys is, dat hierdie regering sekerlik die voorlopers is in die skending van mensenregte in Suid-Afrika. Hierdie regering het met sy sinnelose regulasies nie net gesorg vir die moontlike gruwelike skending van mensenregte nie, maar het ook bygedra tot moontlike lewensverliese. A report issued by the International Commission of Jurists found that South Africa have violated the rights of women and healthcare workers in its response to COVID-19. The lockdowns interrupted or completely shut down health services for women. It disrupted services for survivors of gender-based violence. It led to an increase in violence against women and girls. More women and girls were trapped in abusive environments, and the rape of children in temporary homeless camps is of the tragedies that happened during this government's senseless lockdowns. Probably the biggest violation that took place was the government's failing of healthcare workers by not providing them with adequate personal protective equipment. We all know that corruption with PPEs was indeed sending healthcare workers to their graves, while the thieves are still walking in our streets and reap the rewards of their theft. There were also the problems around quarantine facilities, where the FF Plus had to intervene to get plus minus 1,600 people out of these contaminated places that was not suitable at all for human consumption or accommodation. Not even a street dog would have stayed in these places or eat the rotten food that was served there. Lockdowns have also led to a lack of access to healthcare for other medical emergencies, lower tax revenues to provide social services, starvation and poverty from job losses. Reports state that South Africa are the worst affected by lockdowns due to a lack of financial resources and infrastructure to support people who have lost their jobs due to the collapse of the economy. TB en vigs pasiënte kry nie die nodige behandeling by hospitale en klinieke nie. Hongersnood en wanvoeding is aan die orde van die dag. Die welstand van ons bejaardes en kinders is aan die agteruitgang. Noodsaaklike operasies is nou al vir 'n jaar uitgestel en algemene siektetoestande skakel om in erge siektetoestande en armoede skiet natuurlik die hoogte in. On top of this, 11.1 million people are currently unemployed. We have 200,000 street homeless people. 13.6% of South Africans live in informal dwellings. There is a housing backlog of 2.6 million houses. We have 5.3 million households and 21 million people without clean water. The vaccines that is busy turning into a disaster could also turn into a violation of human rights by the government against the people of South Africa. Then there was four murders, affirmative action, expropriation without compensation, and the latest people who are dying on our roads due to potholes not being repaired and the total collapsing of our municipal infrastructure. This government, who was proud to say and preach for 27 years that they were the forerunners in upholding human rights, and even every year have human rights speeches and festivities, are probably the ones on the end that are the biggest violators of human rights throughout the world. The whole world saw firsthand how this government corruption sent people to their graves and how horribly they have treated the citizens of this country and still do. Daar was en sal nooit enige bevordering van menseregte wees in Suid-Afrika onder 'n ANC bewind nie. Dankie, voorsitter.